Well, that's right. Read them and weep, folks. We probably can't read this, but I'll tell you what's going on inside here because I got blood tests on the new Beast Sports Nutrition Super Test Maximum after a month of use. Super Test Max, let's just call it. Anyway, my name is Mike Roberto. Welcome to Price Plow. This is an online tech and media company where we do supplement reviews, talk about food, diet research, all kinds of things. And I have gotten pretty heavy into the whole biohacking thing. And on this channel, we've already had two videos talking about Super Test Max. We had the formulator, the one and only, the Gorilla Chemist, come on for a podcast episode where he talked about it. And then our co-host here, Ben Kane, who is a power lifter, used it for a month and had some great experiences. But that is not enough for us because we wanted to see a little bit of data. We want to see some blood tests. And the truth be told, Ben, while he is about 10 times stronger than me and absolutely love the product, especially, and I'm going to concur with this, he noticed after getting off of it that things were a little bit less awesome. And the same thing happened here. However, Ben is a young pup. He's super strong and everything. I am actually 37 years old, and I'm kind of getting more into the demographic where testosterone starts to drop. So I did what I am hoping is the first of many, many different blood tests. And I've revealed some of my blood work in the past year, and we're going to do a whole lot more. I got blood tested both before and after a 30-day run. Now, if you follow us on Instagram, follow Price Plow on Instagram, you will note that on the stories, I diligently, very, very, very diligently ran this and took pictures of my pills every single day for the whole month. And I would have that bottle up in the top middle of that stack up there, and I would pull it down, take my pills, take my picture, and I would typically like to use it pre-workout because there is a pump ingredient and there is an ingredient here as kind of a muscle builder as well. It has nothing to do with testosterone. I'm talking about lactogenin. And part of my review is that, I'll just jump into the lactogenin part. I have a feeling that it's not even a huge dose, but I have a feeling that it kind of, and this is like theorized at work, it kind of helped with the joint support too. My left shoulder was doing better and I was able to pump out a little bit more volume, which definitely helped. But anyway, when we're talking to Beast, but first off, let me be fully transparent with y'all here. This product was sent for free and we have an affiliate relationship with Beast, and they, for the 30 days, they had a sidebar ad on our blog. And so the product was actually floating around on the sidebar and chasing it down if you were using the desktop. So this was advertised and everything, no doubt about it. And that's why I wanted to actually get blood work. And I will be honest, my testosterone is actually pretty good given that, my age, 37, and the fact that I sleep terribly lately with the toddler in the house, still not fully sleeping through the night and everything. But testosterone is pretty good. But I have had some run-ins with some low free testosterone, and that's actually the one that kind of is a little bit more important, to be honest. But let's take a look at the latest blood work. So this whole blood work thing for me started, we can link back to the old videos, you don't want to hear about it. But in general, I have high LDL cholesterol, but high HDL cholesterol and very low triglycerides, low HbA1c, low fasting insulin, low blood sugar because of my basically near carnivore keto style diet, high protein, low carb, fats moderate. And so what that did is that put me in this like lean mass hyper responder mode, and I started wanting to tinker around with it. The first thing I decided to do was add 100 grams of carbohydrates per day, which may be very low for some of you. It's kind of low carb. For me, it's actually a little bit higher. And I was able to kind of mess with the LDL number. That's a whole other video that we're going to get into. But in the meantime, while I'm doing these biohacking experiments, I figured I'd also do a supplement review while we're at it. Now, I did the 100 grams of carbs for about 4 weeks. And I kind of got a baseline settled there, but I wasn't like super religious because we're having sleep issues and everything was kind of falling apart. But at that point, I said, okay, time for a 30-day straight solid run here. And that's when y'all saw all the stories on Instagram. So my serum total testosterone at that point, we're talking about, and we'll flash this up here on the side here. So total testosterone measured at 8:54 a.m. on June 5th, 2019, 681 total testosterone, free testosterone, 63.5. Now, that is with total testosterone at my age range, I am proud to say that that is pretty good. That's above average. The reference range is 250 to 827, so I was 681. Now, the free testosterone, I think it's kind of low, personally. 63.5, the reference range there is 46 to 224. Now, there's a whole bunch of things that can mess with your free testosterone. One of them is actually estrogen. My estrogen component at that point was 89. And that range is 60 to 190. So that was okay. Other things that could cause it are oftentimes sex hormone binding globulin, which goes up when you are on a very carnivorous kind of or very low carb kind of diet, and thyroid hormones. So I've been tweaking with a little bit of those in the past, but I got my free testosterone to the reference range. So everything's good, but I would like to have it better. Then came the Super Test Max Run. Boom, 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 boom. Every day, running it, mostly pre-workout, because there is that pump ingredient too. I was talking about Laxogenin. There also is the S7 pump ingredient. So that's the one that I figured, hey, might as well take a pre-workout. I did that and enjoyed a little bit of extra pump there. And yeah, I just said a little bit twice, didn't I? So anyway, here is where things get crazy. So I got a full plan. I did like 6 blood draws on July 5th of 2019. And I will say, this is post one beer. I only had one beer on the 4th of July, but I wasn't happy about that. Also, after a terrible night's sleep. And I got to the lab a little bit later than the first time. And it actually just says here, collected on July 5th of 2019. It doesn't even have a time here. Quest Diagnostics, what's up? So these are both at the same Quest Diagnostics place. But I will say that the second blood draw was a little bit later in the day. But take a look at this. I have never in my life seen a natural testosterone score for myself. Well, no, I've always been natural. So I've never seen a testosterone score like this ever in my life. Total testosterone, 791, nearly 800. We went from 681 to 791 in a matter of a month. That is a not insignificant number. That is a big jump. And free testosterone, up just a little bit. I would say insignificant number. I was at 66.1 as opposed to the 63.5. Either way, I'll take it. Now, I was excited about the free testosterone because there is boron here, and I noticed that, like, all the supplements, all the food I eat, and all the stuff I do, I don't get a whole lot of boron. And boron has been shown to help with free testosterone, so that's possibly part of it. But the big story here is I am this close to 800 testosterone, 37 years old. Man, I really wish I would have gotten my testosterone checked in the 20s. Now, there's a couple things we should talk about. But first, let's get into the diet. So I was religiously having 100 grams of carbs per day, but I was already carbing up a little bit before that. So I don't think that was a huge changing point for me. Further, sleep was up and down. And I really truly believe, and we're going to talk about this, I truly believe that the sleep component is really what's hurting my general health and fitness the most. And this is a temporary part of my life. Like, I'll get this. We'll get this going. It's going to be okay. But the libido with this product, it kicks in for me. It kicked in like 5 or 6 days, and I know an ingredient does it for me. It's not ashwagandha, but I love my ashwagandha. It's the Shilajit. This stuff, I got stories with Shilajit, okay? And this, it's not even like a fully dosed Shilajit or whatever, but whatever Gorilla Chemist did here, it freaking worked. And I am nearly at 800 testosterone with it. But then, and so everything was good. The joints were better. Like overall, the supplement run was awesome. But it's the numbers that I'm just like so excited about. At the same time, you can't, you know, deny the fact that being on the type of diet I am, I think has a contributing role to it, no doubt. Like there's a lot of people who might be watching this like, dude, you almost got your testosterone at 800. How do you do that? First off, I've never done any steroids or pro hormones, so I'm as natty as they come. And you could probably tell I'm not a big looking guy at all. And in fact, the bulk is gonna have to be the next big thing that comes here. Second, and our regular followers are gonna be sick of hearing about this, but I adamantly stay away. I avoid them like the plague. I stay away from the seed oils. Inflammatory, rotten, polyunsaturated omega-6 fatty acids do nothing good for your body and nothing good for your balls. I have a feeling that they are the major contributors to so many things. I've postulated a lot of crazy stuff and I'm gonna continue to do so. But as we see, especially with white males, as we see, our fertility rates and our testosterone levels have been dropping since, let's just say World War II or so. Guess what? We've been doing more and more of the trans fats and also the polyunsaturated omega-6 fatty acids, linoleic acid-based vegetable oils, the industrialized processed seed oils. I avoid those like the plague, especially canola oil, corn oil, soybean oil. Soybean oil, seriously, guys, stay away from that crap. It's everywhere. It's in every processed food. You can't get away from it unless you start cooking your own food. And that's the third thing is I cook a lot. I don't eat out at a lot of restaurants, but I eat a crap load of beef. Not always grass-fed, grass-finished, but I eat a lot of beef. Like, 1.5 to 2 pounds a day. So if you're looking for more than just a supplement, those are my two main things though. Avoid seed oils, eat a lot of beef, don't fear the red meat, and with a little bit, a proper amount, subscribe to the channel if you want to see a little bit more about this, with a proper amount of carbohydrate periodized around the workout, I'm not fearing at all the LDL numbers either. And in fact, I moved myself from the second healthiest group in a few studies to the healthiest group with what I did in this past month. Was beef part of that? Possibly. Shilajit, actually the fulvic acid, can actually lower LDL just a little bit, but I think really it's the carbohydrate periodization at the right time. So I have a low carb but not ultra low carb diet. In general though, this product, I can't say enough good things about it. The way it was formulated, the way it's not just a testosterone booster, and the way that it helps with workouts as well, I think it's a cool little pre-workout add-on. But at the end of the day, the story here is that my testosterone levels nearly hit 800, and I couldn't be prouder of that. But the next question must be like, all right, so your testosterone's high. You're an Italian stallion. Like, what's the deal? Why have you no gains? And to me, I will be honest, I think I went down the low carb route a little too hardcore. My training intensity is a little bit too low, and the sleep component is crap. I do plan on fixing those, and I do think once you become lean enough, I'm about 13, I have one of those scales, it's like 13.1 to 13.5% body fat, depending on how bad I've been. Once you get to a point of leanness, the low-carb diet really doesn't fully make sense, at least not year-round. These things are cyclical. We fatten up in the autumn. That's when the harvest is at, that's when you find the fats and the carbs together, and I haven't taken advantage of that. So there's a lot of things to be learning here. But in general, a beef-heavy, moderately low-carb diet, I think, is gonna be, without the seed oils, I think it's gonna be great for testosterone, and then the support of ingredients such as KSM-66 ashwagandha, clinically dosed here, is huge. Now, onto the story of getting off the supplement. No, you don't need a post-cycle therapy, even though this did jack up my testosterone a good little bit. We're not talking like into the thousands or anything like crazy like that. And oh, that's the other thing. I don't know what happened with Quest here. This is just, they didn't tell me that my blood got drawn. I don't know my estrogen from the second time either. It doesn't feel high. So I honestly, something happened where I don't have the estrogen number, but it was already pretty low. So I'm not expecting anything. It's probably not gonna get any lower. So either way, you don't need post-cycle therapy after taking this. This can actually be used to help with a more serious post-cycle therapy, as it has some stuff to help with your liver and kidneys and all that, and acetyl-L-cysteine, which I love. But in general, no PCT needed. But I'll tell you what, I came off this stuff and things are suddenly, like within a few days, not as good. And I'll tell you why, is I think I've kind of gotten myself hooked on ashwagandha. And I'm not avoiding that. Like right now I'm in a kind of a, let's just say a stressful time of life, and it is a cortisol lowerer. And I've seen with my, if you follow this channel, I wear a constant glucose monitor a lot. I can show you times where I've gotten into, let's just say, stressful situations and the blood sugar goes up. There is no doubt that cortisol is very important to keep low if you're trying to burn fat or make progress in your life, whatever it may be. And sometimes we can't do that all on our own. Sometimes a supplement isn't the worst thing in the world, even if you have a great diet. Ashwagandha is fantastic for me. And so right when I got off of that, I started noticing slightly sloppier sleep than even worse than usual. And I was just, we have to subscribe to the channel because me and Ben are gonna talk about this. I also got struck by lightning, kind of. But I like felt like very ungrounded for a little bit. What fixed it was I went back on ashwagandha using a combination of like Nutrex's multivitamin and occasionally Nutribio's just standard ashwagandha. But honestly, I did not like getting off of this because I forgot to actually get back on a different ashwagandha supplement. And quite honestly, I really like Shilajit and I kind of missed that. So those are two of the three or four main testosterone kind of based ingredients. And I personally do stand by them, and I am personally stoked about the blood numbers. But overall, if you're looking for a natural testosterone booster, I do fully endorse Beast Super Test Max. I thank Gorilla Chemist for putting it together with Beast. I thank Beast for getting Gorilla Chemist involved because I think this is a great add-on. And they still do have Super Test. I actually might want to take that just because Well, I don't know. I'm just kind of curious now. It's like 8 castles per day or 9 castles per day or something like this. This was just 4. So really cool stuff. But overall, I think it's going to come with a combination of getting the proper sleep. And the sleep, for me, the better sleep leads to better workouts. And that's where I've been struggling. And then that could lead to more testosterone. But at the same time, I really do believe a diet is very important. I don't eat a ton of fruits and vegetables. Definitely not the ones that mess me up. I eat a lot of Brussels sprouts. I do eat some spinach, even though a lot of these like carnivore diets are all antioxidants and everything, blah, blah, blah. I like certain vegetables that don't mess me up, but I don't eat a ton of them. I eat a lot of beef. I have a higher fat diet than most people and a lower carb diet than most people. But when I go way too low carb, I think bad things happen to the free testosterone personally. And then I avoid the seed oils like the damn plague. Do those things, and I think you're going to find some better stuff. Now, one of the things that Ben mentioned in his video, I'm just going to kind of just go off the train here. One of the things Ben mentioned in his video, there is also a DHT blocking component here. And so that's where we have fenugreek, which helps prevent the conversion of some of your testosterone to DHT. DHT being the compound, it is very anabolic, by the way, but too much of it, you get the old power alleys here. Now, 37, I've actually been dealing with like a touch of hair loss since I've been like in the late 20s. I kind of noticed it starting to happen, and it's happened. You know, listen, we're not gonna stop it. I'm just gonna age gracefully and I'm gonna enjoy it. But I will tell you this as a fact, that when I started eating the higher beef diet, I got thicker hair. Like I went from eating maybe not enough, half a pound of beef on average per day, probably less, to an average of 1.5 to 2 pounds of beef per day. And this is the same time my wife's like, oh yeah, that shampoo I gave you is working. Well, what she didn't realize is that I was actually not using the shampoo she gave me because it smelled bad. That's why she wasn't using it. And I was using the dollar store stuff because it had like smelled like macadamia oil or whatever. So I was using the cheap dollar store stuff. I was like, that was not the shampoo. That's the higher beef consumption. And my hair thickened out. But don't let me like fool you. This stuff, it's going. It's going to happen. And we're going to love it. It's going to be fine. But at the same time, I will always take something that prevents a little bit of DHT conversion. And with the thickness or whatever is happening with the extra beef consumption, I am like stoked on the combined total results. But I'm not telling anyone to get this because of DHT. The fact of the matter is that this thing is awesome for libido. It's awesome for stress, and that alone can help you get a little bit more natural testosterone. If you're in the tank, it's worth a shot, I guess, but if you're super duper duper in the tank, you might just need to go to the doctor and get a little bit something better. But I do believe that diet plays a serious role in this. And seeing that I had a diet in a good place, I was like in the 700 range, dude, this stuff put me a little bit higher. And for that, I couldn't be more excited. So sucked getting off of it, and that's when you know you had a good supplement run. Thanks to Beast for sending this. Thanks to Beast for working with us, because I'll tell you what, I've wanted to do this for a long time, and it turns out that it had to be me who was the one to actually do this. 30 days straight, like a maniac, blood test before and after, and I might be sending them a bill for that blood work. It really wasn't that expensive. Quest Diagnostics, I went to requestatest.com and got it all done. And then we'll be following up with my lipids and everything, because I think that's actually even a bigger story, but a lot of people are wondering about testosterone. So these are the things that I do to maintain as much Italian stamina as I can up into my 40s. It will eventually dip, and I probably will never go on TRT, and I can tell you about that in a different video, but in the meantime, I'm gonna just ride this as long as I can. And for me, it's diet and occasional use of these supplements to get you through an awesome month. And that's what this was, even when we had some terrible sleep. Thanks again. Check out the blog post, check out the interview with Gorilla Chemist, and check out Ben's review as well. Priceline.com/beast is where we have this. And the next product coming out, you have to sign up for the alerts. The next product coming out is NeuroBeast from Beast Sports Nutrition. And the formula looks awesome. It's a nootropic energy pill. And it looks hardcore, another aggressive supplement formulated by the Gorilla Chemist, but with all compliant stuff, which makes me very excited, just like this one. So thanks again for everyone for watching. Leave your comments below on what you do to keep your testosterone high, and stop watching porn.
Welcome to Price Plow.